Friends, we have one more set of problems based on data interpretation. Here in this case, percentage of marks obtained by various students in various subjects in an examination. There are six students. Their marks in English, Hindi, Science, History, Maths and Geography are given over here. And these are the percentages given over here, as it is given over here, percentages of marks, right? So, suppose we take example of Geography. Out of 40, the marks are given, but here the percentages are given. Like that means he is getting 55%, A is getting 55%, B is getting 65%, C is getting 80%, something like that. Right? Now, let's go to the questions one by one. The first question is, what is the approximated overall percentage obtained by C in examination? Here, we have to find out the overall percentage of C. Now friends, a very simple problem it is. C, the data are already given in percentage, right? So 75, 56, 72, 75, 75, 80. What we have to do? We have to find out the overall percentage. And how we can do that? We just have to add this up, divide by 600 into 100. So precisely what you are doing, you are finding out the average of all these six data. So if we calculate the average of the given data, we can save time by assuming the average, right? Here the three data are 75. So what I do, I assume the average to be 75, right? Then I'll see the deviation from the average, right? Now I assume the average to be 75. Now this is 56, that is 19 less than 75. So that is minus 19, that is minus 3, so that's minus 22, and this is plus 5, right? So minus 22 plus 5, in all minus 17 is there, right? So that means, I just write it over here for better clarity. 75 is the assumed average, minus 17 is the like a deviation from the average. If I divide it by 6, because there are 6 subjects, so it's 17 by 6 is around a bit less than 3, right? So if we subtract 3 from 75, we'll be getting 72, right? So it must be 71 point something in all. So the option closer to that is this, 71, right? So precisely what you are doing, you are just calculating the deviation, right? We assume the mean to be or average to be 75. We calculated the deviation and we find out the average deviation. And we deducted that from, you can deduct or add, right? Because we are getting the deviation to be negative, that's why I'm deducting it. And if you get the deviation to be positive, you have to add that, right? So by this way, you can save your time because you don't have to add up all the numbers, right? So that time will be saved. I hope you are getting me. Now the next question is, what is the difference in the marks obtained by B in English and Maths together and the marks obtained by F in the same subject? Now, the first thing that comes in our mind is, first of all, let's convert the percentages into actual marks. But friends, don't do that. It will be really a time-consuming process, right? You can do this problem without even use of paper and pen, right? Now, listen to me carefully. See, in English, if we talk about the percentage, the base of percentage is also 100 and the total marks are also 100, right? So straight, we can get the difference between B and F. That means B is 88, F is 85. That means B is having plus 3, right? Percentage difference is also 3 and marks difference is also 3. But we have to find out the marks difference so that we will take plus 3. So from B to F, we add... that means B is having more marks, so I take it as plus 3. Now, if we see Maths, here B is having 88% and F is having 74%. So what is the percentage difference? That is 14%. But we are interested in marks difference, right? So 14% is equivalent to, see 150 is what, 3 by 2 of 100, right? So the percentage difference, if we multiply that by 3 by 2, we'll be getting the marks difference, right? So 14 into 3 by 2, that is 21, right? Again, B is ahead of F. So difference between B and F is 21. Earlier it was 3. B is moving ahead. Here B is getting more 21 more marks than F. So 21 plus 3 in all, B is having 24 more marks than F. Right? You can see that we can solve this problem without even touching paper and pen. Right? I hope you are getting me. This question, the marks obtained by E in geography are what percent of the marks obtained by E in Hindi? Once again, very simple problem. No need to touch your paper and pen. E in geography. E has got 75% in geography. So 75% of 40 is what? 3/4 of 40. Right? I have already discussed the fraction to percentage conversion and percentage to fraction conversion in my basic QA sessions. So you must be knowing that 75% is actually 3 by 4. So 3 by 4 of 40 is nothing but 30. That means in geography he is getting 30 marks, right? And in Hindi he is getting 60 marks because the total marks are 100. So he is getting 60 marks. So in Hindi he is getting 60 marks, in geography he is getting 30 marks, that means 50% marks he is getting in geography in compared to Hindi. Okay, so no need to go for any paperwork. This question, what is the overall percentage of marks obtained by D in history and geography together? Now history, D is getting 80% marks of 60, that means he is getting 40 marks, and here 62% of 40, that is 24.8. So total marks he is getting is 48 plus 24.8, that is 72.8. And this is out of 60 plus 40, that is it is out of 100, right? So percentages marks will also be 72.8. No paperwork is required. Now, what is the average marks obtained by all the students together in science? Now science, the marks are from 150 and these are the percentages given. So what we can do, first of all, we can find out the average percentage. Then we multiply that by 3 by 2. So we'll be getting the average marks, right? For even average percentage, what you can do is you can assume an average and then see the deviation, right? Here I assume it to be 80. Now this is plus 2. This is plus 5, it is minus 8, then this is 0, this is minus 12, and this is plus 10, right? So it is 2 plus 7 plus 10, 17 minus 20, that means minus 3. So minus 3 by we have 6 students, right? So it's minus half. That means the average is actually 80 minus half, that we can say 79.5, right? That is the average percentage. So 79.5, if we multiply it by 3 by 2, we'll be getting average marks because earlier we have calculated the average percentage, but the total marks are 150, that is 3 by 2 times of 100. So the total marks, or we can say the average marks, will be 3 by 2 of this percentage, okay? Now how do we calculate that? Since it is around 80, right? Bit less than 80. So half of 80, if we add to 80, we'll be getting 3 by 2 of 80. So that's 120. So the answer should be slightly less than 120, right? Because the difference of half is there. So slightly less than 120, we don't have any option over here. So it's none of these, right? No need to calculate further. I hope you are getting my point. And the percentage, I'm sorry, the average problem should be solved by deviation method. That will be you'll be able to save a lot of time because of that. Okay, now let's take this set of problems. Here percentage profit is the formula is given to us, but that we already know, that is selling price by cost price by cost price into 100, right? That we have already discussed in our basic profit and loss sessions, right? Now profit profit earned by two companies over the given years, it's given over here in the chart, that's company A and company B, right? Now straight we go to the questions. The very first question is, if the income of company B in 2001 was 21.5 lakh and ratio of incomes of company A and B is this, what was the approximate expenditure of company A in 2001? Now, I just make a quick recap over here. See, income is what? Selling price, expenditure is cost price, right? So, we have discussed that SP by CP is equal to profit data. Right? If SP by CP is equal to 1, then there is no profit, no loss. If SP by CP is equal to 1.2, then there is 20% profit. If SP by CP is equal to 0.8, then there is a 20% loss. Right? So that I have already discussed in our basic profit and loss sessions. So here we'll be using the same concept. The income of company B in 2001 was 21.5 lakh. I write it over here. Now income of income ratio of company A and B is 4:5. That means A's income is 4 by 5 of this, because this is B's income. B's income is 5 part, A's income is 4 part out of total. The ratio between A and B is 4:5, right? So A's income will be 4 by 5 of this, right? Now this is income, or we can say selling price divided by cost price that we have to find out, as we have to find out the expenditure, is equal to profit data. Here profit is what? Just see carefully. In 2001, profit of company A, if we see over here, this pink line is of company A. So that is actually 65%. So it must be 1.65. Okay. Now, very simple. 21.4 by 5 by 1.65. That will be cost price, or we can say expenditure. Four fours are 60, 41 point something. So for 430 by 41, around 11 lakh. Okay, so that's this. I hope you are clear. Now see this. If the income of company A in 2000 was equal to its expenditure in 2002, what is the ratio between company's expenditure in year 2000 and 2002 respectively? Now assume that the expenditure into income and expenditure is I1 even in 2000, and in 2002 it's I2 E2, right? So in the first year, I1 by even is equal to profit data. So in 2000, that's profit data is 50%, so it's 1.5. In the second year, the income is I2, and profit over here in 2002 is 55%, right? 55%. So instead of I2, I can write 1.55 E2 by expenditure in the second year was income in the first year. So here I'll be writing even, and that's again 1.55, right? This is I2. I2 by I1 is profit data, and I2 can be written as like this. Okay, so 1.55, 1.55 cancelled. If you multiply both of them, I1 by even into E2 by I1, this I1 and I1 will be cancelled. So we'll be getting E2 by even as 1.5, that's 3 by 2. So even by E2 is 2 by 3. Right? Now here, if the total expenditure of two companies in 2003 was 15 lakh and expenditure of company A and B in that year were in ratio 3:2 respectively, then what was income of company B in that year? Now very simple questions, friends. That expenditure ratio is given, that is 3:2, and the total expenditure is 15 lakh. That means expenditure of A and B is 3/5 of 15 and 2/5 of 15, that's 9 and 6 lakh, right? Now profit percent in year 2003 for company B is 50%, right? Profit percent is 50%. So income by expenditure is 1.5. So income is 1.5 into 6, that's 9 lakh. Right? I hope you are clear. This question: if the income of company A in 1998 was equal to expenditure of company B in 1999, then what was the ratio of expenditure of company A in 1998 to income of company B in 1999? I assume company A I1 even, and for company B it's I2 E2, right? So I1 by E1 for company A in 1998 is 40%, so that's 1.4, right? Now in 1999 for company B, it's I2 by E2, that's 1999 company B, that is 50%, so that's 1.5. now let's multiply both of them. So I1 by E1 into I2 by E2 is 1.4 into 1.5. now income of company A in 1998 was equal to expenditure of company B in 1999. That means I1 is equal to E2, so I1 and E2 is cancelled, right? Now what we want? Ratio of expenditure of company A to the income of company B, right? So that's what we want, E1 by I2. Here we are having I2 by E1, so I simplify that and then I'll reverse the ratio. So that's 21 is to 10, so the answer must be 10 is to 21. So that's this. I hope you are clear. Friends, you can save this much space if you write both of them like besides each other, right? So that this much space and rewriting time of this expression can be saved. I have space problem, so I haven't written it, but you can do this, right? Now in this question, if the total income of company A in all the years together was equal to the total expenditure of company B all the years together, which was rupees 485 lakh, what was the total percentage profit earned by company A for all the years together? Friends, we cannot calculate that because the total income is given, but in case of profit, individual years profit is given. So we need to have individual years expenditure as well. So that cannot be calculated with this given data. So it cannot be determined. Okay, no need to waste time. Now this question, what was the difference between total production of companies E and F in the given years? Do it faster. Just find out the difference quickly. Here this is company E, this is company F. 208, 520, that's 312. Write down the positive difference. I am taking F as the bigger number. Here it is 486, 380, that means it is minus of 106. Then it is plus 302, then it is minus of 80, then it is around, we can take because options are giving us that margin, so it's a minus 50 around, and this is minus 15 around. So just this 12, this 2, 12 and 2, 14, deduct it. 300 and 300, 600 minus 100 is 500, 500 minus 130. So it's around 270, 265, right? That's we don't have in the options. So that's none of these. Okay. I hope you are clear. Now, what was the percentage fall in production of company C in 2000 over that in 1999? Company C from 1999 to 2000. So that is actually 23 by 421, 23 by 421 into 100. Just get an approximate idea. So that's 230 by 42. That means 42 into 5 is 210. So it's more than that. So it must be around 5.46 among the options. Okay. And how the idea will be, you'll get the idea. Half of 42 is 21. Right, so 420, that's 10 times, plus half of 42, that is 21, so it's bit less than 5.5. okay. Now production of company B in 1999 was what percent of the total production of all the companies together for that year, rounded off the nearest integer. So we have to add up all this data. Options are having good margins of 4 to 6%. So still to be faster, five, just approximate this calculation, must be around 30. Around 30, just write 0, carry on 3. The second row is also around 30, carry on 3, write 3. Particularly for this, do not approximate much because that will produce a difference of hundreds, right? So 5, 6, 7 and 3, 10 and 4, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 and we have carried, right? So precisely it is 387 by 2, 2, 3, this is, right? I'm sorry, it is in 200. So if I delete this, it will be this 3870 by 223. Further, to be faster, I will remove this 3, this 0, and this 0. Now it is 22 ones are 16 is carry on 167. So 22 into 8 is 176. So it is a bit less than 8, so it's 17 point something, that's 18%. Okay, I hope you are clear. Now, approximately what was the average production of all the six companies in the year 2000? That means we have to find out the average of this line. Okay, so as usual, we will be like taking assumed mean method to save time, some time. So I see among the options, if I see the options are closer to 400 to 500, right? So I assume, and 500 cannot be the mean because there is just single data which is crossing 500. All the other data are below 500. So 500 cannot be the right choice. Okay. So what we do is I assume the mean to be 420, right? Now I find out the difference of 420 from this and put a negative, a positive sign. So this is minus 2, this is plus 20, plus 6, this is minus 22, this is 108, I'm sorry, 98, 92, then this is plus 66 and this is minus 20, minus 40. Now simply this, this and this is around 64, so we cancel this. So we are left with 92 plus 6, that is around 98, or we can say it's around 100, right? So the mean deviation or the mean average, that's mean deviation will be 100 by 6, that is 16 point something or around 17, right? So 420 plus 16, 17 will be 437. So that's the correct choice. Okay. And just keep this thing in mind. Never ever copy the data, right? Just go for the assumed mean method. So you'll be able to save your time to a great extent, right? And just approximate your calculation because just see, options, they are giving us the margin. See, 412, 37, 66, around a margin of 30, 40 is there, right? So if you play with 2 or 3 or 5, it doesn't matter for us, right? To like simplify our calculation, we can do that.